that if I need to, you know, send a message specifically to one browser or to a group of browsers, that I would be able to do that.
That's true. And I have some fantastic slides from Anthony Chu that I was about to show you that actually exemplify that.
Okay. Let's see them.
Before I do that, though, let me actually hop into code for 1 second. And what I'll do is I'll open up this rotation hub. Okay, so this is my rotation hub in that last demo. And there's more code in this demo than I'll show you in kind of the end-to-end as we kind of build stuff up later demo. What I wanted to show you here is essentially like, we're talking about C# here, .NET. So I have this class called a rotation hub, and it inherits from a class called Microsoft Asynchronous Core SignalR Hub. And this is just like an abstract class. And what it will give you is, if you see here, you've got clients. That's essentially the same thing as me going this dot clients. And then as you called out, in the code that I'm probably using, I'm using all. And what that does is that says, I want to send a message to all of the clients that happen to be connected to me at this point in time. You might not always want to do that. So in that case, we've got ideas for things like caller and other clients and that kind of stuff. But let me show you what that looks like visually. I think that makes a little bit better kind of an idea. So this is a beautiful slide from Anthony Chu. And what this does, I hope he didn't show you this when he was on the show already.
He didn't.
Good. Okay. I want to steal the slides. So essentially we have all these clients. So these might be all the different clients that want to see the 3D thing spinning in space for insert reason here. If I wanted to target all of them, what I could do is I could say clients.all.send message. So whatever method I'm going to fire. And this is kind of what the code used to look like. And we would just basically send an argument. You can see here that I'm sending a string. You can send it pretty much anything that's, serializable. And it'll just serialize it on the wire. We actually have support, the default is JSON. But we also have support for message pack. So if you wanted to go with message pack, it's smaller, more compressed, probably transmits faster. If you wanted to use message pack, you could actually opt for using the message pack providers, serialization provider, and then it won't serialize your stuff as JSON anymore. So I do want to point that out. So you can send complex objects. But in this case, you can see I'm doing clients.all.send message and then some sort of a parameter. And all the clients light up and they get stuff. So what I can do next is I can go right here and I can say, I only want to target one user. Now, this is what's important. You saw that I had a couple of different browsers open. Each one of those browsers would be targeting me as a user. Like I'm going to be a user. So as long as you can, identify me by my username. If you were to call this, my phone would light up, two browsers would light up, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So this is a way for you to target one individual user. If I wanted to, I could target a group. In this case, if I was presenting in Vegas, I might want to target all the people that happen to be in the Vegas group. And in this case, I would just use .groups, put a string in there, and it would actually go out and target all of those individual, the people that are in that group. You do have to add people to groups. So that is something that you would have to do in your own code. And we don't do something like have a list of groups for you. That's something that whenever you add somebody to a group, you would probably also want to add a record to a database saying that that person is in that group, et cetera, et cetera. So I do want to point that out, that we don't do all of the work for you. But we do kind of set it up for you to basically give you the capability of being the signaler. That's essentially what it is. It just gives you the ability to signal between these individual clients.
Okay. So it sounds like I, as the developer, get control then over what it is that I want to identify as a group or how it is that I want to identify users. So if I want to do it, based on an auth principle or maybe based on a location or whatever it is, that I have that flexibility to decide how it is that I want to set up my users and how I want to set up my groups.
Yes, that's true. For example, we'll talk about it a little bit today, the Azure SignalR service. Anthony's way better at that topic than myself. One of the things that we talk about with the Azure SignalR service is like if you, I think each individual instance can support something like 100,000 concurrent connections, which is pretty good if you think about it. If you want to do more than that, then you have to add instances. So, you know, if you would add an instance like in the East and an instance in the West, maybe what you do is you group your users and you say, if you connect from the East, I'm going to put you in that instance. If you connect from the West, I'm going to put you in that instance. So that's actually one way, if you get into very, very, very high, you know, like high user count type scenarios, that's one scenario where you can actually bifurcate your users and put them into individual instances of your Azure SignalR service.